I mean, on one level, it's like 30 years ago, right? As though nothing has changed. It's a bit weird. Yeah. I mean, but at the core of it, we live in this very peculiar situation where the role of the dollar in global finance is just idiotically more important than the US economy. So if a strong economy translates directly into a higher dollar, some of these things just sort of follow like night and day.
In financial markets, but in the real world, does that create an opportunity then?
I think yes, it does. It definitely creates an opportunity for those in the peculiar world of finance that can have a genuine medium to long-term position, which I suspect isn't that easy these days. Never was, but probably not. But there is another caveat. Is of course, it's at a time where China is slowing down. So how the strengthening dollar itself plays into the Chinese issues as China is trying to stop itself slowing is definitely an additional complication for the, let's call it this ridiculous phrase, emerging markets. Quite why they're still called that, I no idea, but there you go.
Now, once upon a time, we called them BRICS, didn't
there
we?
There you go.
Who came up with that?
I don't know.
Some bloke.
Whoever it was, he got two of them wrong, that's for sure.
Can we ask about some of those then? Because it's quite a mess. You talk about Brazil and this endemic corruption as we come up to an election not far off from that. We're in countdown mode. Mm. India, economy growing rapidly, yet the market's concerned it's done no work in the background to try and improve its fiscal position, still has huge importing needs on oil. And then China, as you mentioned, slowing down, and Russia, I mean, all sorts of sanctions, issues around oil as well.
Yeah.
So have we moved, I mean, you talk about 30 years ago, have we moved at all in any of these countries improving the position? And is it right that now we get a dollar move and central banks having to tighten in response to the Fed, that we are right back into a sell-off or a swoon moment for
India? You know, I go back even further to the only real full annual 1 year long, in fact, Swiss bank days that I lived through in 94. And it's not just EM. I mean, I suspect Italy's going to have, I don't know why I'm saying this because I don't even follow this stuff day to day, but I would imagine Italy's going to have a nightmare of a day to day, given US bond yields doing that and what I just picked up with you quoting from the policymakers there. So it's not just as though it's EM. They're the ones that get the highlight, but you know, the kingpin role of US policy and the dollar in world finance is an issue. You know, the US economy over those same 30 years has gone to less than 20% of world GDP, and yet the dollar is seemingly playing this dramatic role.
It's also a very important point you just said a minute ago, that looking at emerging markets that we talk about, and we should talk about the individual countries, there is a poor part which has got, you know, poor account positions, you know, what they're doing on their capital account, where they're suffering.
Which color is that these days? Because I thought there were some good ones, like India and Indonesia, but now apparently they're not good ones either. So which were the good ones,
you know,
and which
on
were
the
bad ones?
Just on India, you know, again, I'm thinking of another 98 that I've seen some people saying, oh, here we go, it's going to be like the Asian crisis, and India's mentioned. But India has a floating exchange rate, and okay, the rupee's dropping, but you know, that's probably a rational thing. It would be more worrying, in my view, given India's current account, if they were trying to stick to some kind of pegging of the exchange rate, which would just bust eventually, like the Thai baht did in 97, 98. So, yeah, they're getting dragged into it all, and they have got a current account deficit, and of course they're a massive oil importer, but famous last words, I would have thought India is not a place that's going to have a catastrophic consequence of this, where there's, you know, the Turkeys, who are so dependent on easy foreign capital. If this carries on in the US, then, you know, some of those places are going to struggle.
Hey, everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now, to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.